going, and then once it's going, you'll see the benefits of it all. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But it, like I said, it just takes time and it takes a lot of effort and it takes, you know, you got to have a strive and a passion for it, and you do, so just keep moving forward and you'll enjoy it. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
You'll enjoy it. And the good thing with Brian is he wants to pick different locations, from what I understand, to cook the food. So he has a different look every time we film it. It's going to be a different look, different location. So I really enjoy that part of this. You know what I mean? We're going to have our podcast here where we talk about the podcast, what he's cooking, what the menu is for the week. But then we're also going to have the live photo, the live on KBLP LLC. And it'll be available on everybody's involved with us and all friends and families. You know, we're hoping everybody shares it. So make sure everybody shares it as many times as possible, so it gets well known and people get to see what Brian could do as far as cooking in the kitchen. You know what I mean? And do what he does. So did you lay out the form? So you said it was a breakfast today though that you're making, right?
Yeah, it's breakfast. Just your typical American breakfast sausage that were discounted, you know, at the store, you know, because they're getting close to expired date. But they're still good. You cook them through and everything's fine. You know, some of the vegetables I got, you know, they're fine. Just got to wash them. They're just blemished or something like that. Something that you don't like. You know, not none of that perfect fruit they sell in the expensive stores. You know, it's just fruit that just is not very appealing to the eye sometimes. But fruit or vegetables, but it all works, you know, because it all gets put thrown in the same pot. But if anybody has any questions, I'm not real good with technology, so you can look me up on Brian, BRIANCASIAS. I have a black muscle shirt, and I'm holding a Mountain Dew cup. And if you have anything, just so you know who I am. That's who I am. And if you have any questions or whatever, because I'm not real good with technology, I'm trying to figure out how to do this, and hope you guys give me a chance. I really appreciate it. Thanks.
It's going to be good, man. So I know you appreciate everybody that listens and everybody that's a part of this. I want to know what other food plates you have coming up that you... I know it's weekly, but I just want to get an insight on what food plates you have that you're interested in preparing for everybody.
I do Italian food sometimes. I do, you know, I guess white boy type stir fry or whatever. I mean, I posted this morning. I made a pho. A friend that I know. His name's Keo, and it's called actually pho. You know, he's from Laos. So that's what it's called. Anyway, they call it pho out here or whatever. But I made that this morning. That's why I was telling you guys, look at my page, Brian Casillas, CASIAS. I'm at the top of the page. I have a Mountain Dew cup. There it is. A Mountain Dew cup is in my picture right there. And you can look at some of the food that I posted. I posted Italian sausages with peppers, homemade meatballs. I can do Parmesan, eggplant Parmesan. I could do chicken Alfredo, fresh Alfredo sauce, homemade meatballs, fried liver and onions. I don't know, some of you might not like it, but I do. I can make menudo. I don't really mess around with pozole. Don't like it too much because it's kind of too dry. Just the pork is.
How about your menudo? How about your menudo? How do you feel? Because I'm a big menudo fan.
Oh, yeah. I'm halfway decent on it, you know. It's all right. It just depends. I also make homemade marinara sauce, fresh basil leaves. I grow basil. I grow tomatoes. Well, mom grows them, you know, but I make a fresh marinara sauce, which is pretty much just garlic, you know, olive oil, some crushed tomatoes, and maybe just a little pinch of sugar and a little pinch of salt to get rid of the acidity. But, I mean, like I said, I've been watching cooking shows for a long time. And, I don't know, any suggestions, like I said, hit me up on my page on suggestions of, or any ideas or anything that you could do to help me out. I'd appreciate it. I don't know, is that about it? I think we're about time, right?
Yeah. You just... Also, we want to, you know, we're throwing it out there for sponsorships. Anybody who'd like to sponsor a food show, that's pretty good because, like I said, we need sponsorships to make this move forward because, we're going to be doing a live podcast every Saturday at 3 o'clock. And then also, we're going to be doing, from KBLP LLC, we're going to be doing prep. And then we're going to be doing the final product. As soon as the product's done, we're going to be posting the product. So the prep will be on there. The prep will be on there so you could check it out. I'm sorry, I'm getting messages as I'm talking to you guys. Every time I get messages, I start looking at it. And prep. Chris Stevens is on right now. What's up, Chris Stevens? Say what's up, man. Chris Stevens is on.
How you doing, Chris? Thanks for giving me a chance.
He does our Freaks in the Basement. Pretty good show.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's on every Friday. And Michelle's on. They're going off in the comments. In the what you call it. So yeah, so moving forward here, as soon as we get done, the prep should be available in KBLP. On my page, and then also it would be available on Brian's page here in a second. I'm just waiting for it to get sent to me, and then as soon as the product is done, we will be posting the final product. You know, he likes to dress the product up, so the food up, so when it gets done, it's gonna look really nice. So, and if you have, like I said, any questions, get a hold of Brian Casillas on his Facebook. You could leave messages on our chat, and then also KBLP LLC. You could leave messages right there if you'd like more information, or even guests. How do you feel about guests? Are you willing to bring on guests every once in a while?
Well, yes. This morning I actually did it for my cousin. I made, like I said, I was talking earlier. I made pho, and like I said, if you look on my page, I posted it. His name's Joshua Mendoza. That's who I made it for this morning.
Yeah.
That's the American version. I tried one of them from Vietnam with the star anise and ginger and like that, and it just tasted odd to me. So I did pretty much, you know, a chicken, vegetable type, you know, a caldo, you know, which a caldo is just, you know, a soup or something, with chicken, carrots, you know, and stuff like that, and rice noodles. But just check it out. You know, I tried to do it the best that I could. You know, like I said, I'm a beginner. I know nothing yet about the recording or about anything like that, but I do know how to get around the kitchen. So, Ike, back to you. Are we done yet?
Yeah. The last thing I want to ask you, man, is I'm a big barbecue fan. What do you have for us coming up as far as barbecue?
I can show you some barbecue stuff. I'm not a pit master or nothing like that. Like I said, once we get the video down and stuff like I would like to do it, I can show you guys a little bit. I mean, there's people on YouTube that show you that stuff. You know, that's fine. I just have a different way of doing it. Some of the other people like to pull off the back of it. That's kind of difficult at times. It's not as easy as it looks, like the professionals make it look. I do it a different way. I just leave it on, and I'll show you that in a time that I decide to make it within this 12 weeks.
Are you talking about pork, or are you talking about beef, or what kind of barbecue are you talking about?
I'm probably talking about pork.
Pork? Pulling the pork then?
Unless somebody could pay for the beef, but I can't really. Pork is pretty much pork and chicken.
You know? Pork and chicken is what you barbecue?
Yeah.
Okay. That sounds really good, dude. All right, so we're going to go on to a couple jams. I want to thank Brian Casillas. You can catch him every Saturday, 3 to 4 And it's we're gonna build up his podcast, and then also, like I said, with his podcast, we're gonna be adding video to it, so it's gonna be a lot more exciting. That way, he can explain it to you over the podcast, and then show you with the video. So I think that everybody's really gonna enjoy it. So we're trying to move towards where we do video and podcasting at the same time. So it's pretty cool. So be on the lookout for the prep that we did today, and then also be on the lookout for the final product that we will be releasing here in a little bit. So,
because I'm gonna go back in the kitchen right now and go finish it up.
Yeah, he's finishing up the food now. So we're gonna be eating good here in a minute. I can't wait. I'm excited. We're gonna throw down. But all right, I'm gonna get into a song. Have a good day, guys. I'm gonna get into a couple songs. We got Lori Wood coming up with Soundtracks right after this. So make sure you check out Soundtracks. It's an awesome podcast. Thank you, Brian Casillas.
Thank you all.
Every morning at the mine, you could see him arrive. He stood 6'6" and weighed 245, kind of broad at the shoulder and narrow at the hip. And everybody knew you didn't give no lip to Big John.
Big John, Big John,
Big Bad John,
Big John.
Nobody seemed to know where John called home. He just drifted into town and stayed all alone. He didn't say much, he was kind of quiet and shy. And if you spoke at all, you just said hi to Big John. Somebody said he came from New Orleans, where he got in a fight over a Cajun queen, and a crashing blow from a huge right hand sent a Louisiana fella to the promised land. Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
Then came the day at the bottom of the mine when a timber cracked and men started crying. Miners were praying and hearts beat fast, and everybody thought that they'd breathed their last except John. Through the dust and the smoke of this man-made hell walked a giant of a man that the miners knew well, grabbed a sagging timber and gave out with a groan, and like a giant oak tree just stood there alone, Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
And with all of his strength, he gave a mighty shove. Then a miner yelled out, "There's a light up above." And 20 men scrambled from a would-be grave. And now there's only one left down there to save Big John. With jacks and timbers, they started back down. Then came that rumble way down in the ground. And as smoke and gas belched out of that mine, everybody knew it was the end of the line for Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
Now they never reopened that worthless pit. They just placed a marble stand in front of it. These few words are written on that stand. At the bottom of this mine lies a big, big man. Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.